expressing degree of certainty in the present time. Degree of certainty refers to how sure we are about a case. In degree certainty in the present, we should know the case in some level. There is the case that less than 50%, and then 95%, and then 100% sure. And how to analyze of degree of certainty in the present? Let's we take. Okay, the case when the bell rang, all the students come in the class, and the teacher asks, "Why is not John in the class?" Related to this case, the student just give their opinion. Why is John absent? If the student have no idea and they do not know the proof, the student could be respond, "He could be sick, he might be sick, or he might be sick." Here means the response less than 50% sure, because the student have no idea, they have no proof or the information. And how if the student have an idea, they know the little proof about the case, they have information about the case. Okay, for example, last night one of students saw John. The student saw John near a drugstore, but the student didn't know John buy medicine for himself or no. And the example above was the proof, but the proof need confirmation, right? So we could use the next level in 95% sure. We can use he must be sick. Next, another student has new information. Yeah, as we know that social media give us more information, right? Another student say that John was sick because it is appear in John profile in WhatsApp. The last proof was confirmed that John is really sick. So we use the highest level of degree of certainty with 100% sure. So on this case, we use he is sick. In the conclusion, degree of certainty in the present less than 15%, we use model could, might, and maybe. Next, 95% sure, we use must. But when 100% sure, we don't use model, but we use to be. Okay, karena itu subjeknya he, maka to be-nya adalah is. Jadi he is sick. Saya ulangi ya. Untuk degree of certainty in the present, kita menggunakan 3 level kepastian akan suatu hal, suatu kasus. Seperti contoh di atas. Kenapa sih John tidak masuk ke kelas? Apa respon yang diberikan? Siswa akan memberi respon sesuai apa yang mereka pikirkan. Bu guru, mungkin John terlambat. Bu guru, mungkin John sakit. Bu guru, mungkin John malas soalnya banyak PR misalnya dan sebagainya. But they have no proof. They just give suggestion without evidence. Okay, mereka hanya mereka tidak memiliki fakta. Mereka hanya memberikan apa ya? Ide mereka saja yang terlintas di pikiran mereka. Makanya kepastiannya less than 50%. Okay? Kurang dari 50%. Next, jika terdapat siswa yang memiliki sedikit saja bukti atau little evidence, misalnya nih, "Oh iya Bu Guru, tadi malam itu saya bertemu, saya melihat John nih di apotek, dia memberi obat. Mungkin dia itu memberi obat untuk dirinya gitu. Jadi karena John itu sakit gitu." Nah, Pada level ini, tingkat degree of certainty meningkat menjadi 95% karena ada fakta, sedikit fakta, okay? Sedikit fakta kalau John itu pergi ke apotek dan dia membeli obat. Makanya kita menggunakan he must be sick. Oke. Loh, kok cuma 95%? Kok enggak 100% sih? Karena hal tersebut hanya terlihat aja, okay, kan? Belum dipastikan. Sehingga untuk 100% kita itu butuh konfirmasi, okay? Kita butuh kepastian, benar atau tidak. Nah, ternyata salah seorang siswa membuka status WA John nih, gitu. Sekarang kan WA itu menjadi sumber berita tercepat ya. Nah, di sana ada foto John yang sedang sakit. Nah, ini adalah salah satu bentuk dari konfirmasi. Barulah kita menggunakan level of degree certainty in the presence-nya menggunakan he is sick means 100% sure that John is sick. Okay. Sekali lagi, degree of certainty need proof, evidence and logical conclusion. Okay, sekian, terima kasih. Okay, please look at on the exercise 48. There are some exercise for you. Okay, here I will give you the example, just one example. Okay, exercise 24, number one. Blah 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 is yawning. She is yawning. Why? Nah, di situ ada kita melihat orang atau seseorang dia itu sedang menguap. Berarti kalau menguap itu bukan lagi yang namanya less than 15% sure, berarti kita sudah punya asumsi dari fakta yang kita lihat, berarti itu adalah 95% sure, sehingga kita bisa menggunakan he must be sleep. Kenapa sih kok 95, kok nggak 100 aja? Karena kita belum konfirmasi dengan orang tersebut. Setelah kita konfirmasi, kamu ngantuk nggak sih, gitu. Kalau dia jawab iya, berarti benar. Jawabannya adalah baru 100% sure. Tetapi ketika kita hanya melihat si is yawning, berarti itu adalah 95% sure. Kita menggunakan he must be sleep. Seperti itu ya.